Hi guys, and welcome back to the Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild for our latest walkthrough at Tuppence Magazine. And we're just about to head up these hills, and as you can see, it's chucking it down with rain. So we're going to be stuck to the main path because we can't climb the mountains, which would make it a lot easier, and we'd be able to avoid all the nasties along the way if it wasn't for that. But every now and again, you can kind of get away with it, so maybe we'll try that once in a while. But the main gist is we've got to climb this mountain, climb through the path, and get to the Zora Kingdom. So we're going to head off and do that now. So you just kind of keep on tracking up. And there's a few nasties for you to take on along the way. This is the bridge that you will have seen in the earlier walkthrough. So we're just going to head back over here. And it really doesn't take long. Inogo Bridge. It doesn't take long before you start to come into contact with some of the gits on the path. So there you can see is the first one, the Lizanfos. Try and ping him in the head, which we did. That's been dealt with. Now the good thing about this walkway is that there's quite a few arrows. As you can see, there's bundles lying around and in little stashes along the way. So we're kind of going to use the arrows quite frequently, especially against these little gits. Because otherwise they just keep hurling stuff at you, which is really frustrating. And honestly, it's really worthwhile picking up stuff along the way just to get a little bit more energy back every now and again. You can see the lizard coming over there. Oh, disappeared. Disappeared. It's probably not a good idea to waste too many on that dude. So you just keep heading up, picking up some octo balloon along the way, and we should be able to see this octo here. Get rid of him. This dude gonna come over and start a little fracas. Stay where he is. He's seeing me, he's seeing me. Thinking about doing something, but I think we can kind of get away with it. So we're just gonna ignore that dude and head up this hill. Because there is this dude here. Yeah. That's right, sister. Well, that's him dealt with. Okay, so as you can see, there is quite a few little bundles of arrows, which is good, so make sure you pick those up along the way. Smash all the boxes and pick up everything that falls out. Also smash the barrels, just in case. Some more arrows. I think we're okay for a bow. This is probably going to go soon. This will be fine. Just going to give that a switch as well. Yeah, I thought it was going to go soon. So then we're going to pick up this Traveler's Sword. However, the Traveler's Sword is no good against those crates. It just kind of bounces off them. So we're going to change that to the Soldier's Claymore. And head on up this hill. Oh yeah. Come on then. Oh, what a git. These are cheers. There we go. It's really good to kind of run in and get your hits in as quickly as possible where you can. The longer you wait, the kind of more time you give them to get in their attacks. I'm not going to try and kill a squirrel. That would just be brutal. Okay, so along here, I think we're going to see a few more octos. Be ready with the bow and arrow. Here we go. With one of the fellas. One done. wasting arrows now. There we go, it's two done. Okay, so as I say, it's kind of worth using the arrows and just taking those gits out along the way. And picking up everything that you can, and you just kind of keep following this path around. And eventually you'll come to Prince Sidon again, who'll have another little chat with you. And here's another one of these dudes. Oh, disappeared with you. There we go, that's that one done. So just use your arrows where you can. We're just going to do a little bit of mining while we're here. So we're just going to drop that bomb. Detonate it. The bomb. Like that. And just sort of pick up all the bits and bobs. There's a ruby there that come flying off. Something might have flown away a little bit too far. Here we go. Shrooms. And then we got some flint as well. It's just kind of good to pick up stuff along the way as you're going. Just makes good use of time. And just sort of always hunt down the little nooks and crannies to see what else there is to get. Let's see, there's a silent shroom there. Which you can concoct. Away. Okay, so you will have just seen a little cutscene with Prince Sidon, and he will have just said, it's tough up ahead, there's a lot more monsters for you to take on. But you know, don't get put off. Keep on trucking. That's our advice. So we're just going to head up this hill a little bit more, and we're trying to weave slowly around. Taking on all the nasties along the way. And getting smashed on the rocks. Destroyed. Wow. That was harsh. Okay, if you do find yourself down here, it's worth just trying to climb up. It's not so easy. Especially if you get smashed by the rocks. Okay, so as you can see, climbing isn't easy either, but you can do it little bits and pieces, so just sort of do that when you can, and if you do get smashed, just use a little bit of food to bring some health back to you. And obviously watch out for falling boulders. Say, just get in your hits as quick as possible and pick up all the arrows along the way. Definitely come in handy. Another arrow there. Some shrooms. Let's see. There's a color up there. Hearty truffle, lovely. And I think it's worthwhile just heading up there and just dealing with this fella. Because he's got. We got somebody else? Can I see somebody else? Sure, we heard something there. Over there, is he? Or just sort of ignore that fella. He's got a roasted bass. Beautiful. And again, we're just going to do a bit of mining along the way. Grab the flint. Grab the extra bass. Grab the arrows. More bass. We're going to take the shield. Oh, I've got too many shields. That is not like me at all. Oh, sweet. Okay, all right. We'll drop the wooden shield. Who wants a wooden shield when you've got a lethal shield? Okay, so there we go. Now we can continue to head on up. We're just going to quickly check the map to see how close we're getting. And you can see we are not getting close whatsoever. But we're just going to head up here. Hi, dude. Where's he gone? Oof, just got in the hit. Again, grab all the bits and pieces as you go in. Can we use the bow and arrow? Oh, so close. So close to you, dude. Okay, so we're back, having just been vaguely destroyed along the way. But what we're going to try to do is just be a bit more cannier about getting this stuff. Okay, we may have got a perfect hit. I think there's one more, dude. Yeah. Been spotted by some fella. You done? Okay, so as you can see, they have got the electricity, and that will just literally kill you instantly if they get you. So you kind of want to keep hiding, keep drawing this fella over if you can. Beautiful, perfect hit. Yeah, you should be scared, dude. Okay, but the problem is they've got the electricity, so they can take you out straight away. So unless you get a perfect hit on them. Just get enough arrows at them. Ooh, just moved in time then. edge around. Let's try and get a better view on this. He's seen us. Did it. Think. Nah, I can hear some more. Where are they going to be? Ah, there's the fella. Okay, so there's a large compound and there's two of them over there just firing away. What do we want to do? Open this crate. The soldier's bow. Our inventory is full, despite the fact. We just had a traveler's bow, that's why. So we're just going to drop that. Some kids, always quite useful. I'm sure we took this dude out last time. Clearly he's come back to life. So, we got a fair bit of kit there. You might want to avoid it if you don't want to go through the rigmarole of all that, but kind of that kit will come in handy later on. So I'm just gonna try and find a way and through. Ideally, we can get over to the other side of this ledge. It'll be a little bit easier to make it up the hill. Okay, we want to be to the right of where we are now, pretty much behind us. So now we're back on track. Let's see. Just fly on over. And hopefully, this will mean. Just about avoided that craziness. And we've done a little shortcut there, I think just a little bit. We want to head down to the right and then circle around. Yeah. Brilliant. So we've got a few guys to destroy here. This fella just licking himself. That's right, you want to lick yourself, that's okay. They're not going to judge you. But it did look a bit weird. Anyway, so that's that done. We may have lost that, but we do get those wins and some lovely bass. Make sure you don't blow up that explosives and grab everything else. But we may not need it. Okay, I think there's another cutscene coming up now. Okay, so Sidon's just said we're pretty much up to the most difficult part of the trip up. We're gonna have lots of nasties to fight. So I don't know why we're back where we were. Just get across this bridge. Okay, and then we need to head, once we do get across this bridge, I think we need to head around to the left. Hey dude. Yeah, don't worry about your weapons. Who needs that? Burning away in the fire. That was harsh. Okay, more bass. Beautiful. Bucker spear. No, I definitely do not need that. Okay, there we go. Another bass. I'm gonna head up here. It kind of looks like the path's there, but we're gonna try and avoid some of that where we can and see if we can't go a little bit off-road. I'm not sure how long we'll be able to maneuver here. Maybe not very long. It might save us a bit of time if we can do it. Which we might not be able to. Just gonna recuperate a little bit. Might be a little bit beyond. Yeah. Okay, so that section's beyond Link's capabilities. In the howling rain. We're just gonna press on, because I'm pretty sure is some little shortcuts along here. I'm gonna try and exploit them a little bit. So we've made it around here, and what we want to do is head around there to the left. Okay. Let's see if we can climb this. It's not. It's more promising. Brilliant. Okay, so we're getting a little bit closer and hopefully avoiding some of the nasties along the way. Hot-footed frog. And picked up some shroomage. Just gonna check the map again. We kind of need to be around to the right here, and then that should lead us all the way down. Yeah, okay, so there's the bridge. So now we've got to make our way through. I think a few Zelfos. As well, so okay, grab ourselves a nice bright-eyed crab. And there's these kind of things to examine along the way. Okay, so they just give you little bits of information about the history of the Zora people. Okay, we need to be on that bridge. We've still got a little bit of climbing to do. So we're going to try and head around here. Through. You kind of don't know it, but you've avoided quite a lot of nasties by taking this route and just kind of made it a lot easier than going all the way around. And it just shows everything about not being able to climb in the rain isn't entirely true. Again, we're getting quite close. We're not going to head back along that bridge. And again, we want to try and cut across there. That's where we want to get to. I'm not sure how far we'll be able to get. Maybe if I jump off there. I might be able to travel all the way over to there. Just going to give that a go. See how far we can get. Big if, really. Sure, he's going to do it. Here we go. Oh, we may just do it. We can just land behind this dude. Ah, we made it. Amazing. Now then, let's see. Yes, hello, sir. Sit yourself down. Why did you even bother? Okay, so that's Moblin dealt with. Just gonna crack in a new weapon. Just take on something rubbish like the Traveler's Sword for a little bit. Okay, so we're getting quite close now. And this is the homeward stretch. And you have no idea how many Lizanfos you've missed as a result of taking that little hike around the back there. But honestly, it does help. Because you've made it here pretty unscathed. And in all fairness, we took on some fights that we just didn't need to in the end. We could have just kind of ignored them and trekked around. You don't get enough cool stuff by taking them on. It kind of isn't worth all the efforts. So here you go. Welcome to the Zora's Kingdom. And we will be picking up with the rest of this walkthrough in our next video. Thanks, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe and stay safe. Cheers. Bye.